over everything. Everything in your life, everything that you look to, everything that you're concerned with, God is Lord over, right? But He gives you, as you partner with Him, authority over some things in your life.
Yes.
So that you can partner with Him and actually attain and go after the thing He has for you.
Yes.
So let's just continue to press in this morning. You just sing the song. We worship You, Jesus. That's all we want, is more of You, Lord, in our life. So we can be more like You in our life. Because nothing else really matters when it's all summed up in the end, and we step out of this life into the next life. Really, what we did here, life goes by like that. And so what we do and how we see things and how we live our lives, it's all really going to come to nothing except for what did you do for Him. If it really is about giving your life to Jesus, about giving your life to God, and that's what it's all about, right? That's why we come to church. That's why we give our tithe. That's why we commit our life to this thing, because it really is all supposed to be about Him, not about our marriages or our whatever, family, friends. That's all good, and it means something, and there's supposed to be a heart and a love there. But at the end of the day, it's about Him.
Amen.
And everything comes back to Him. We give our life to You this morning, fresh and anew. Every day we wake up and we say, God, it's about You. Help us, Lord. Hallelujah. every broken heart, every broken place, every place that's been stepped on, every place that's been abused, every word that was spoken negative over somebody's life, Lord, that wasn't you, Jesus. God, we break the power of those words right now in Jesus' name. Every word spoken over this church, every word spoken over the purpose and destiny of this house, God, we break it right now in Jesus' name. No devil in hell can stand to the power of Jesus. Nothing can stand. He paid the price. It's broken over your life, over your mind. Whatever's happening around you, whether chaos is breaking out, God wants to speak to you in that place. He wants to show you exactly what He has for your life. The problem is when we get close to God, when we start feeling God, all that stuff in our life starts to come up, and our mind starts to fill with those things that are there that, but God, if I get close, then I got to deal with this. And we start to kind of push back in a moment. And He starts to come. He says, no, I want you to come. And all those things start to happen where we start feeling that. But if I do, I know I have to let go of this. Or if I do, maybe it means my life's going to change. And I'm comfortable in my misery. Even though I'm miserable, I'm too scared to step out of this place. Because if I do, I know responsibility and everything is going to come on me. And I got to step up. Lord, we don't want to miss out on the life that You have for us here on earth. It's really about God and everything that He has for us as we're walking with Him, and everything that He has assigned for our life. The more we let go, the more that we die to ourselves, He says that He'll raise up His life in us. So if that's what we're really seeking after, then some of the things in our life, they really don't matter. They really don't have a place, because all it becomes is just a distraction. Sometimes it's people, sometimes it's things. The world likes to come in and dazzle you and lure you in slow, step by step. And next thing you know, you're not even pursuing God. God's kind of just in the background. And you're just living life doing it your way. But He has a better way for us. In Him?
Amen.
Amen.
More aware of Your presence.